Starting live video. People of Earth, how are you? Saturday, December 4th, 2021. Good evening and welcome to Variant 82, Episode 82 of the House Arrest Concert Series. Nice and cold. With me, your host and sole performer, Bill Spence. Coming to you live from Mount Laurel, New Jersey. It's kind of a best of, well, not a best of show tonight. It's just, I only worked one new number tonight. All the rest I've played before. Hopefully you've enjoyed before, and hopefully you'll enjoy them again. So, from 1976, John Miles from his 1976 album Rebel. I'll tell you more about John Miles after I check my recording device.
Hey, people are here. Yay. Nancy, Lucy, thank you for watching. Thanks, yes, I will keep on coming. And
so John Miles, as with a lot of the people that I showcase here on my little talent show, was bigger in the UK than he was in the US. His 1976 debut album, Rebel, only made it to number 171 on the Billboard charts in the US. Though we had a couple top 20 hits in the UK from that album. High Fly was number 17, 68 in the US, and Music, number 3 hit in the UK. It was produced by Alan Parsons of the Alan Parsons Project, a number of songs for which John Miles sang lead vocals. That was done at Abbey Road Studios, and of course that's all in the news lately with the ridiculously long documentary on the Beatles. But I'm not going to talk about that. There's much more history to talk about today. This is December 4th. It is Play Outside Day. Hope you got a chance to do that today. The first Saturday of every month is National Play Outside Day, so. But ever so more importantly, it is Rhubarb Vodka Day. And it is Cookie Day. So have yourself a biscuit, have yourself a rhubarb vodka, go to town. Birthdays today, the dude. Jeff Bridges, 72 years old today. Tyra Banks, 48. Wink Martindale, Tic-Tac-Doe fame, is 87. Max Baer Jr., Jethro Bodine, is 84. And 1964, born on this day, was Marissa Tomei. She's 57. Jay-Z is 52. And on this day in 1993, the other end of that life spectrum, Frank Zappa passed away at the age of 52. And his death was one that kind of prompted me and should prompt everyone to, you know, get regular prostate exams, because that's what he died from. 1947. On Broadway, A Streetcar Named Desire premiered tonight, starring Marlon Brando and Jessica Tandy. This is 1947. They were both pretty darn young. What else? I think that's all I got for now. That's what I want to do. Sure. Was written by a guy named David Pomerantz, who over the years, projects and records that he's been involved in have gained like 22 platinum records, 18 gold records. He's still responsible for selling 40 million records, but you've never heard of him. You may have heard of some of his songs. In his early days, he would be an opening act for Rod Stewart, Billy Joel, Three Dog Night, The Doors, and Barry Manilow in 1976 had a number 10 single with this song of his. Doctor, my woman is coming back home late today. give me something. Cause the feeling is gone, and I must get it back right away. Speaking of variants, one band that had many, many variants over the years was Fleetwood Mac. And in 1972, their album Bare Trees came out. That was kind of in their Bob Welch, Danny Kirwan era. Welch was with the band from 71 to 74, Danny Kirwan 68 to 72. This was also a number 10 hit for Bob Welch himself on his 1977 album, French Kiss.
That's why I've traveled far, 'cause I come so together.
together where you are. Yes, and all of the things that I said that I wanted come rushing by in my head when I'm with you. 14 joys and a will to be married. All of the things that they say are very sad. This is from my favorite Steely Dan album and their least favorite, 1975, Katie Lied. Number 13, they were not happy with the recording process. I like this song. Is close again.
words of love can never screen the flash I feel. I'll make you understand. Honey, can't you see? I know it's real, it's got to be. Why not chase it where it goes?
Okidoki. 1964, originally recorded live in a live recording by the Kingston Trio. Written by a guy named Chet Powers, whose stage name was Dino Valenti. I never understood that because Chet Powers is a perfectly good stage name, but he had some issues. Dino was in the Quicksilver Messenger Service. But the guy and the band who made this a number five hit in 1969 was Jesse Colin Young and the Youngbloods, and you'll remember this.
But a song we sing, and fear's the way we die. You can make the mountains ring, or make the angels cry. And though the bird is on the wing, you may not know. Thank you.
Tuesday, August 5th, 1969. I was 14 years old. This is the first concert I went to. It was in Lambertville, at a place called the Lambertville Music Circus. It ran from 1949 to 1970. And it was theater and music in the round. It had a rotating stage underneath a circus tent. It was a very cool place and a great place for me to go see my first rock and roll concert at age 14. This song was the first one that this band recorded. Transit Authority from the first album. They had no hits off that album. They had two hits off of Chicago, or Chicago 2, their second album, Make Me Smile and 25 or 64. And then after the two of those charted, then they released Does Anybody Really Know What Time It Is? And I'm going to tell you what time it is. It's straight up 8 o'clock. And that is all the covers that I have no business doing. So I'm going to do one more of Mayans that I hope you might enjoy. You know, on this day in 1982, Scandal, Patti Smyth and Scandal performed Goodbye to You on American Bandstand. It was kind of around this time they performed on a morning gig at the the bottom line in New York, where a band of mine was featured. We didn't play, but we, my dear departed old friend and musical collaborator, Charlie McKinless, the two of us wrote a song called Finally Friday, submitted it to WNEW in New York. Their Friday morning show was called Finally Friday. And they played a recording of that, and they had, you know, just a little mini festival. And Patti Smith and Scandal played a few songs there. And that was my nearest brush with being famous. This is another song that Charlie and I wrote. Just about how things are often very, very hectic. Episode 82 of the House Arrest Concert Series. Enjoy it on Facebook tonight. Streaming on Hulu tomorrow. No, that's not true. But give me about 45 minutes and it will be up on the archive on BillSpence.com, which you can go and enjoy. And send all your non-Facebook friends to. Yeah, just go to BillSmiths.com. You will find it. And I'll get to work right on that. And next week, the 11th, there will be no show, as I will be doing a family Christmas party. It will be a Zoom party. But, you know, that's what we do these days. Armagerd, Armicron. Thank God there are a lot of letters in the Greek alphabet, so we can just muddle on, hopefully to the Omega and be done with this. Anyway, so in 2 weeks' time, I will be back with episode 83 of the House Arrest Concert series. Thanks for joining me, and until next time, ciao, ciao.